We want to solve the given linear equation in one variable by isolating the variable on one side of the equation. And notice what's different about this type of equation is that we have variable terms, or in this case, x terms on both sides of the equation. So we're not going to be able to isolate x if it's on both sides of the equation. So our first goal here is to either undo the positive 7 on the right side of the equation or undo the positive 9x on the left side of the equation. So we have to decide if we want to subtract 7x on both sides of the equation to eliminate the x term on the right side, or if we want to subtract 9x on both sides of the equation to eliminate the 9x on the left side. Either technique will result in the same solution, but in this case, let's go ahead and subtract 7x on both sides of the equation. Again, the reason we're doing this is, looking at the right side, 7x minus 7x would be 0, so now there's no longer an x term on the right side of the equation. Now going back over to the left side, we have 9x minus 7x, that's 2x. We still have plus 4, we bring down the equal sign, and here we have positive 15. Now we have our basic two-step equation, so in order to isolate the variable, we have to undo this addition and undo this multiplication. But referring to our guidelines, we know we want to undo addition or subtraction before we undo any multiplication or division. So in this case, we'll subtract 4 on both sides of the equation. Again, notice here we have 4 minus 4, that's 0. So we're left with 2x equals 15 minus 4, that's 11. And then to undo the multiplication here, we have to divide both sides by 2. 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1. 1 times x is x equals, and then 11 and 2 don't have any common factors, so 11 halves is our simplified fraction, or simplified improper fraction. But if we need to express this as a mixed number, we would have to divide 11 by 2. Let's go ahead and do that. 11 divided by 2, there's 5 2's in 11. 5 times 2 is 10, the remainder of 1. Which means 11 halves is equivalent to 5. Then the fraction part is the remainder over the divisor, so we have 5 and 1 half. Now remember, if we want to, we can always go back and check these. What that means is if we go back to the original equation and replace x with 11 halves, or 5 and a half, it would satisfy this equation, or the left side would be equal to the right side. And you may want to do that just to verify the solution for yourself. I hope this was helpful.